Bananas are one of the most popular and widely consumed fruits worldwide. Every year, millions of tons of bananas are harvested and consumed by people in various parts of the world. Like coconut trees, banana plants can grow in almost all parts of the world, to be precise, and they can grow in 135 countries worldwide. India and China occupy the top positions as countries with the largest banana producers. More than 1,000 varieties of bananas are increasing worldwide, ranging from the bananas we usually encounter in local markets to more exotic varieties. Each variety certainly has its unique taste, texture, and characteristics. In this video, Technologia will invite you to see the process of modern banana farming in mainland Latin America, such as Ecuador and Brazil. Banana trees can grow in a variety of climatic conditions. However, to produce high-quality bananas, farmers must meet several conditions, one of which is climate. Most modern banana farms are in the equatorial region, which has a tropical climate with warm temperatures throughout the year and high rainfall. This climate suits banana growth and production, requiring stable temperatures and high humidity. Furthermore, banana trees need lots of sunlight to grow and bear fruit well. The equatorial region has high levels of sunlight, allowing optimal growth and production of bananas. The first step a farmer takes is preparing the field. Preparing a field includes choosing a suitable location, clearing the land of weeds, twigs, and making soil beds and drainage to meet water needs. This kind of field preparation process can be done more quickly with the help of heavy equipment. Cultivating banana trees can be done in several ways, and the most commonly used is seeding with saplings or rhizomes because it is relatively easier and cheaper. Unfortunately, this method has many areas for improvement, such as the limited number of seeds from the parent and the possibility of disease transmission and pest attacks. So, to get banana tree seeds in large fields like this, farmers will use tissue culture techniques. This will allow farmers to increase the number of banana plants quickly. Each piece of tissue, small part of a plant that is grown and propagated using tissue culture techniques planted in culture media, can quickly develop into a new plant. In addition, farmers can select and isolate plant parts of banana trees that have desired characteristics, such as disease resistance or high productivity. Once the banana plant seeds are large enough to be planted in the field, workers will take the banana tree seeds to the prepared field. Some farmers use plastic mulch when planting banana seeds. Workers can immediately plant banana seeds in each hole provided. Plastic mulch is useful for controlling weeds and reducing water evaporation from the soil surface. Meanwhile, farmers who do not use plastic mulch at the beginning of their growth will install a spray irrigation hose that will automatically water the plants and the surrounding soil. This aims to maintain the soil moisture plants need, producing optimal growth. The distance between banana plants in each row usually ranges from 2 to 3 meters, with the distance between each row ranging from 3 to 4 meters. The seeds of this plant take between 5 and 6 months to produce banana flowers or banana blossoms. However, before these banana trees bear fruit, farmers must maintain the banana plants by watering them and applying appropriate fertilizer. Watering banana trees can be done automatically using an integrated irrigation system. Meanwhile, banana plants are fertilized manually, either by applying organic or inorganic fertilizer, which is adjusted to the needs and analysis of the soil in the banana tree fields. Meanwhile, to control pests, farmers will deploy tractors equipped with reservoirs. This tractor has a fan that sprays pesticide liquid along the agricultural land. This nursing process takes place continuously throughout the banana tree's growth cycle. After the banana blossoms grow, the bananas will take another 3 months to be harvested. When the banana seeds start to grow, workers will put partitions between the banana cones and then cover the entire banana with a blue plastic bag to protect it from insects or disease. Once the bananas are the required size and firmness, workers can start harvesting them. This process begins with workers measuring the thickness of the banana using the tools provided. Next, workers put thicker pads between the banana cones to avoid bumps and bruises during travel. When picking bananas, one must be very careful because bananas can easily be damaged. Bananas from large farmers like this are usually picked when they are still green, or between 65 and 75% ripe, depending on market demand. If fruit is picked too ripe, it can cause damage during transportation and have a shorter shelf life. Meanwhile, if the fruit is picked too young, the quality and taste of the fruit will not be optimal. Next, the banana bunches that have been cut from the trees will be transported using the banana harvesting cableway. Harvesting transportation like this is commonly used on banana plantations because it is more effective, especially on large land areas and far from processing areas. This transportation machine can also transport 48 banana bunches at once. These banana bunches will be transported carefully from the field to the packing area. After arriving at the packing area, workers spray with water and cut each banana cone from the bunch. Each banana bunch is then put into a pool of water to clean it of dirt and prevent the sap from falling onto the banana skin. Then, the bananas are graded and categorized based on size and quality. Bananas that are not suitable for export are removed and sold on local markets. Meanwhile, the number of bananas that meet the criteria will be reduced and cleaned again using water. Next, the worker labels the product and packs it in a cardboard box. These boxes are taken to the warehouse before being sent to the port for shipment to the destination country. During the storage and shipping process, the banana cartons are kept at 13.5 degrees Celsius to prevent them from ripening too quickly. After these boxes arrive in the destination country, these bananas will be placed in a ripening warehouse until they reach ideal ripeness before being sent to each nearby market.